Hi guys and welcome to Motorbeam. So I'm at the Mumbai airport right now, flying after a year. Yes, I've come to the airport after a year. The last time I flew was in March 2020. I had gone to Chennai for the Hyundai plant visit to see the all new Creta. And right now we are going to Goa. So with me is Javed and Zubair is also there. He's waiting outside.
So Javed, are you excited to fly after so many months?
It's honestly awesome. Now the thing is, Pati, you've not been to the airport after a year. You went in March, no? We are still in Feb. I have actually been after a year. The last trip I did was Auto Expo. I came back on 7th of Feb, so it's actually after a year. And it feels really, really nice to be back and to be going for a drive event.
So we are done having breakfast at the lounge and now we are heading to the gate for boarding the flight. And we'll see you in Goa.
People feel that you are enjoying it and all. Nobody bloody sees. Subha 5 baje uthke niklo, take a flight, go there, immediately start shooting, driving, understand, raat ko product presentation, and then you talk to the management and all. Raat ko sote sote 2 baj jate.
No time to eat and sleep during the
nothing.
Ride.
And then morning you get up at 5 o'clock, flag off at 6 o'clock, and then you keep driving, shooting, and go drop the car to the airport. Everyone feels, wow, what life, you're driving all the cars. At least see the effort which it goes into this.
No,
and not only our, the whole team. Like once we come back, one of us goes to office, drops the footage. The editor is editing all night. So it's a lot of effort.
No one sees all that. They just think, haan, Goa ja
rahe hain. Maza aa raha hai, ash karke aa rahe hain.
Excited to fly after a year.
You are going to chill, na?
Very excited.
So flying in COVID time means you have to wear face shield and mask. But honestly, this face shield is so much better than the one we wear in clinic. That's like that studs wala helmet wala that is so heavy. So honestly for me wearing this is like a piece of cake. But you should wear. So you know, path looks like you're going to the space station.
I'm going to the thing, Mars.
So we have landed in Goa, we are heading to the hotel and today is day one, so we'll be shooting some static shots of the car, we'll be chilling on the beach for a while and then later the plan is tomorrow we'll go and do a detailed shoot of the car, we'll shoot the PTCs, the tracking shots, the beauty shots, all that and we'll also do the Hindi video tomorrow. So Zubair, what is the plan for today?
Plan for today?
Zubair is expecting. Zubair, shaadi kab kar rahe
ho? No such plans.
One margarita, one zafrani paneer tikka, 3 shahi tukdas, 1 mutton seekh kebab, what else?
1 chicken tikka.
1 chicken tikka.
And fresh lime soda sweet.
And 3 fresh lime soda sweet.
Bas ho gaya? Tum to kya khaoge?
So before a hard day's work, you have to eat. And eat whatever comes your way. If it's healthy, good. If it's not healthy, eat because it's a long shoot and we won't have any time. Chalo, Zubair, lunch up.
Art. Take a camera, hold karo, log kar rahe hain. Start karte hain.
So many pieces of shahi tukda. Zubair and Javed, you guys have to finish it along with all this food.
Now that you mention it, you're not
going to
have one bite of anything.
I'll have one full plate of that.
You know how capable we are, huh? We can actually finish all of this.
Extremely capable and durable we are. So we are heading to the other hotel to shoot the Kiger and have a look at the car. And this is what we are going in. The Duster Turbo.
Have you driven diesel? Chalai hai kya?
डीजल चलेंगे ना सब चलेंगे मर्सिडीज से लेके हर
नहीं ये डस्टर का डीजल चला है
हाँ चला है ना
तो डस्टर डीजल अच्छा लगा है या ये पेट्रोल
पेट्रोल बहुत बढ़िया लगा मुझे अभी
जो Uber has started shooting the car. We're taking some beauty shots. We cannot drive the car on day one, so we are finishing some static shots of the car so that there is less load for tomorrow. Hopefully tomorrow also we'll shoot the same blue car. We have not one, not two, but three Kaigers with us, all of them in different colors. Now all of them are the manual variants, and we are shooting some beauty shots of the car, and that is Zubair balancing the camera on the gimbal.
So finally, after taking a flight after one full year, coming all the way to Goa, checking in the hotel, now we are finally having the car in front of us. And what I really like about it first up is the sculpted bumper and the sculpted bonnet, and those three-pod LED headlamps look really awesome.
I think the design looks great, it looks proportionate, and Renault is offering some nice colors also. Yes, the front does bear some resemblance to the Kwid. It looks like a bigger version of the Kwid from some angles. So that may or may not be a good thing for a car of this segment, but otherwise no issues on the design front.
But if you see, the Kwid also looks quite good in its class, so I think they just carried forward that design legacy.
Yeah,
but that's a good thing. Let's move on. I think this is the best part of this car. If you see, these tail lamps give it a three-dimensional effect, which looks really cool.
The tail lamps look cool, and you also have this sculpted thing on the tailgate. And along with that, you have this nice Kaiger badging. So nothing over the top, nothing too flashy. The design looks youthful, it looks appealing, and yeah.
I think the blackened treatment which they've given to the roof and to the, you know, the C-pillar and all, it looks really nice.
So the cost for the dual tone option is rupees 17,000, I guess, over the regular.
I think the price overall is quite competitive. I think even the colors, if you see the grey, the blue and the red, it looks really young and vibrant.
Now even if you look at the car from the side, there's nothing that can go wrong with the design. It looks pleasing to the eye, it won't offend anyone. And the 16-inch alloy wheels also have a very tasty design.
And they very tastefully added all the SUV elements like high ground clearance, which is definitely needed, and those black cladding on the bumper. And I really love these roof rails, which are actually usable. So, you know, you can actually mount a rack on top of that. So, design-wise, I think I would rate it quite high.
The design is good, the feature list is good, and tomorrow we are looking forward to driving this car. So, we'll tell you more about this car in detail tomorrow.
What mileage will you get?
Sir, so I'm trying to ask everyone what mileage everyone is getting, because I'm comparing what we are getting, and I realize that Mumbai is the most congested city in the world because there is absolutely no mileage whatever car you are driving.
It is day 2 of the Renault Kiger drive. We are at the beach shooting the introduction for the Hindi video, and that is Zubair again setting up the camera. Javed is trying to go for a jog. Abhi camera band ho gaya, he'll be back. Trying to burn the calories of the shahi tukda.
Obviously.
So we are at the hotel shooting the Hindi video. We are just wrapping up the static shoot of the Hindi video. That is Javed packing up the stuff and having some refreshments. This Duster Turbo is our support car, and we are leaving now for another shoot location. We'll be doing the driving PTC, the moving shots over there, and we'll also finish the English video over there.
Very hot. This is the second shirt I've changed since morning.
I'm also sweating a lot. Too humid over here. I'm seated in the rear seat of the Kiger. Javed is driving the car, and we are heading to the shoot location. Space is quite good at the rear. The legroom is more than the venue and the Sonet actually. And Javed is 6 feet 2 inches tall. I'm 6 feet tall. Legroom is still more than enough. Headroom is quite good. But the seat is not very wide, so 3 people cannot sit comfortably. It is best meant for 2.5 men. Now if you talk about the features at the rear, you get 2 AC vents, you get a single charging port, you get this nice armrest with a slot to keep your mobile phone and 2 cup holders, and obviously you get a bottle holder in each of the rear doors. For the rear seats, you also get Isofix child seat mounts, you get 2 adjustable headrests, no headrests for the center passenger, and this car also comes with 4 airbags on the top variant, while the low variants come with 2 airbags. Now there is no traction control on this car. The Nissan Magnite comes with that feature, but I think it does not really need a traction control feature. So Javed, you seem to be enjoying revving the 1-liter turbo engine. So how's the performance like? What kind of drivability are you getting?
So right now, I'm actually just comparing it in my head between the naturally aspirated, which I'm actually using in the Triber right now. So it's kind of fresh, and this 1 liter is quite good, much better, very well suited for people like us who are enthusiasts. Now this engine, it has a bit of turbo lag, but it really comes alive after 2000 rpm. The mid range is solid, the high end is very good, and of course this engine is going to be the one which enthusiasts will pick.
The ride quality also does seem quite good. The car is comfortable, it is planned. There is a bit of a vertical movement that I can feel, but the ride does not make you feel too unsettled. It is quite composed and the car feels quite planned.
Actually, I'm driving a little enthusiastically, but yes, the steering feel and feedback is also quite average. There's nothing to complain on that front. मुझे थोड़ी पता तू मुझ पे गिरने वाले हो.
Now Javed was driving the car a bit too enthusiastically, so Zubair got scared. So now I'm in the driver's seat, and this is the turbo petrol manual variant. But before that, I'll talk about the naturally aspirated engine, which makes 72 PS and 96 Newton meters of torque. Now that engine is offered with a 5-speed manual or a 5-speed AMT, the same as the Renault Triber. Now performance from that engine isn't that great. It is not too enthusiastic. It is more commuterish, and it suits those people who want a spacious, feature-loaded compact SUV, which is value for money, yet they do not care about performance. They want better fuel efficiency, and obviously the AMT is well suited for people who want a two-pedal driving experience, because the AMT is any day more convenient than a manual. Yes, it is not as smooth as a CVT or any proper automatic gearbox, but it works well for city driving conditions. Now talking about the main engine, which I'm driving right now, is the 1-liter 3-cylinder turbo unit. The same engine is offered on the Nissan Magnite, and it makes 100 PS and 160 Newton meters. This is also offered with a 5-speed manual, and you also get the option of an Xtronic CVT. Now performance from this engine is quite good. It is enthusiastic, much better than the naturally aspirated engine. Turbo lag is felt, the mid-range is strong, it pulls the car very nicely, and the top end is also decent, not that great, but it works well, and most people won't complain about the drivability. So once the car comes alive after 2000 rpm, the acceleration is quite brisk, and you also get three driving modes. So you get Eco, Sport and Normal driving modes. The car is in normal mode by default, and in Sport mode it feels more eager, while in Eco mode you obviously can churn out some extra kilometers per liter, and the performance becomes a bit sedate. Talking about the fuel efficiency, well, you can expect around 10 to 11 kilometers per liter from both the engines while driving in the city, and out on the highways the number can go as high as 14 to 15 kilometers per liter. But obviously if you drive the turbo engined car well, it can churn out better figures compared to the NA engine. Now the fuel efficiency of the turbo petrol engine is actually a double-edged sword. So if you drive the car sedately, if you are very careful, and if you keep it in the proper band in the RPM range, you can expect good fuel efficiency numbers. If you push the car hard or if you drive it very enthusiastically, the numbers can drop and can go much below than the numbers that are offered by the NA engine. Now talking about the CVT, well, I haven't driven the Kiger CVT yet, but I've been hearing some good things about it, and Renault has tuned the CVT in a way that it reduces the rubber band effect, and it is a very good thing that Renault is offering a proper automatic instead of an AMT with the turbo petrol engine. In fact, this is one of the better automatic gearboxes below rupees 10 lakhs. Now the Renault Kiger is quite loaded with features, and the first thing that you notice is the digital instrument cluster. Now the size of the screen is the same as the Nissan Magnite, but the quality of the graphics on this one is better, and the color theme of the instrument cluster changes depending on the driving mode. So it changes to blue if you switch to normal mode, in Eco mode it goes to green, and Sport mode it becomes red. So that is a interesting thing. Apart from that, you get an 8-inch touchscreen infotainment system with Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, all those connectivity options. The sound quality is decent. It is not very, you know, audiophile-ish, but it is good for the price. Apart from that, you get automatic climate control, keyless go with push button start, you get a wireless mobile charging pad, and there are some features which are also missing. So you do not get a sunroof, there's no connected car features, there's no 360 degree camera that is present on the Nissan Magnite, but this car does get an air purifier. Along with that, there are a lot of storage spaces and cubby holes inside the cabin. So under the front center armrest, you get a large storage area.
You also get large bottle holders in every door, and there's a space to keep your mobile phone or a wallet below the AC controls as well. The Renault Kiger also has the biggest boot in its segment with a capacity of 405 liters.
So Parth, how were your last 2 days in Goa?
Last 2 days in Goa were quite good, quite interesting actually. I enjoyed coming to Goa after so long, shooting a car, driving at a different location. So I'm grateful that we are moving towards normalcy slowly and steadily.
I think the best part is it gives us time to do what we actually love to do, to drive the car, to experience it, and then tell you guys what we actually experienced and felt about the car. And of course, coming to a new location gives a different perspective also. So tell me, what do you think about the car?
I think it is a great package for the price. I mean, Renault has nailed it.
I think the biggest thing for Indian customers is the price and for what they get in that price.
I've made a list of 5 pros and 4 cons of this car. Talking about the pros, the first pro would definitely be the cabin space. Legroom is quite good, better than most of its rivals like
and
the Venue and the Sonet.
Both of us are 6 feet tall. So, you know, that is one issue we always face in most cars, but this is perfectly done.
The space management is quite good inside the cabin, and the second pro for me would be the feature list. For the price, you get a very nice, very impressive feature list. And the third pro would be the engine performance from the 1-liter turbo unit.
I think turbo petrols definitely, you know, they are the engines which can give you good mileage, give you good performance, best of both worlds in one. And now tell me, what do you think are the cons of this car?
Well, I haven't mentioned all the pros yet. Okay. So the fourth pro is the ride quality. The suspension is nicely, you know, set up, and it works well for our roads. It is pliant, comfortable, not as good as the Renault Duster, obviously, but it does not feel uncomfortable by any means.
I think Renault cars, all of them have great suspension setup. Now let's move to the cons.
There's one more pro, the pricing of this car, which is
that
so value for money.
I already mentioned that, so I think you should get to your cons now.
Cons. Now talking about the first con, it is not a proper con actually. The styling of this car is similar to that of the Kwid from the front especially.
So I think they've tried to carry forward the design language, and because the proportions are not so wide, at least in the photographs, it does look very Kwidish, but in real, it has its own road presence. So yes, I would say a little bit of a con.
The second con would be the NVH levels of the car. They are acceptable but not that good. A lot of sound from outside filters inside the cabin, so that is something that could be worked upon.
Maybe in the facelift. And the third one?
Third con would be the fact that there's no diesel engine. I think
Renault has all decided that they are done with diesels. There are going to be no more diesels. And I think that is one reason why they're able to extract better interior space, because they've pushed forward the engine bay. So, you know, extract more room in the cabin and boot.
The final con is the quality of the interior. It is not bad at all. It is acceptable for the price, but it could be a bit more plush. It feels average, built to a cost actually. Certain parts, not the entire cabin obviously.
I think they've done a great job considering they've priced it so aggressively and yet given us a good product. So guys, what do you think about this car? Please tell us in the comment section below. And don't forget to tell us whether you like this vlog style of reviewing or you like the traditional formal, hi guys, I'm, you know, talking about this car. Tell us in the comment section below. We'll try to implement it from the next video onwards. Right, Parth?
Yes, and we'll see you in the next one. Till then, stay tuned and watch this space for more.
And don't forget to subscribe to the Motorbeam channel if you haven't. Like, share and comment. See you next time.
Bye-bye.
After a long day, having some nice, tasty Bombay-style food in Goa before flying back, way better.
How is it Bombay-style? Goa-style?
Nice, not bad.